Hello. Nice to see so many familiar faces in here. For those of you who don't know much about the Vancouver Economic Commission, it's the economic development agency for the city of Vancouver. So we do a number of different things. About half of them are around solving challenges for local businesses in Vancouver. And about the other half of what we do is connecting work. So connecting businesses with mentors, capital, employees, and trade channels that they need to grow their businesses locally in Vancouver and internationally. So today I'm just going to give you a little bit of context about the False Creek Flats, which is where this arterial goes through in terms of the planning area, about businesses that are in that area, the role that they play in the city at large, and about some of the challenges that these types of businesses are facing across the city. And then we'll get into a little bit of some of the aspirations for this area that came out from the most recent planning process, which wrapped up almost 2 years ago now. So looking at what role this part of the city should play in the future. So can we go to the first slide? Thanks. So the False Creek Flats is a central industrial district in Vancouver, which means that it serves a lot of the rest of the city. So it's about 15% of the city's industrial land that we have left. And over the years, we've seen a lot of that industrial land disappear. It's gone to housing, and it's gone to social services, and it's gone to creating new roads, etc. And so our industrial land is a really precious resource now. So the False Creek Flats actually houses about 10% of our manufacturing and wholesale and distribution jobs in the city. And it plays a really important role across many sectors. There's about 150 artists, artisans, and cultural organizations operating in the flats. Many of the businesses there utilize fleets, and so they have the back of house services for our tourism industry, for all of our recycling that happens in the commercial and industrial or in the office towers downtown, as well as it's a really important hub for our startups. So traditionally, industrial land has been the kind of cheap, easily accessible space for startups to grow up in Vancouver. And so that's been really critical, a really critical role that the Flats has played. Can you go to the next slide? So the Flats is also changing really significantly over the next 15 years. We're expecting the number of jobs here to triple, and we're expecting there to be about 90,000 residents within a 10-minute walking radius of the False Creek Flats. There's also a huge new hospital project taking place right at the corner of approximately Main Street and Prior Medicals. And there's a new university campus on the other side of the flat. So a huge amount more walking, biking, driving, and living activity happening in this area. In addition to that, the port is increasing its operations significantly, again, over the next 15, 20 years, anticipating that their container volume is gonna go up by 70%. So that's a lot more rail traffic as well as truck traffic coming from the port that's just to the So I want to talk a little bit about some of the industrial trends and challenges that we're seeing in the city, because this industrial land resource is so precious. About 60% of our industrial businesses are actively expanding. So when we see industrial operations in the city, sometimes people tend to say, oh, those are legacy businesses or they belong in the outskirts. But in actual fact, the businesses that are operating within the city are typically doing so because they need to be close to downtown and close to their clients and employees. So about 70% of the businesses in the flats said that was absolutely critical to their operations. We're also seeing a real integration of technology into many of these organizations so that the trucking is becoming cleaner and less noisy. The warehousing as well as manufacturing is becoming more automated, and we're seeing the built form as well as the infrastructure that goes along with that changing as well. So As I said earlier, we've lost a lot of industrial land in the city, and because of that, there's only about a 1.4% vacancy rate for industrial land in the city, which means it's really, really hard to find new locations. So any businesses that could be displaced through a process of putting in a new road will have a very, very difficult time finding industrial space in Vancouver and even in the region. The cost of doing business is going up significantly, so the investments that businesses have made in their current locations are really critical. So I wanted to talk a little bit about the policy context in the area and some of the additional resources that are out there to give you an idea of what's happening with the business community here. As I said, we went through a local area planning process and economic development strategy process over the last several years. And so within that, we engaged a number of businesses from across the Falls Creek Flats as well as across the city to say, what should the flats look like in the future and what role can it play? And there's kind of two sides to that. On one hand, it plays this very, very important and functional role for serving the rest of the city, serving all of our offices and houses and doing all of our repair and distribution functions. And at the same time, is a critical startup space for many new and emerging industrial technology companies, such as clean technology, biotech, etc. And so in terms of economic planning, what we're looking at across the city and across the region is the critical role of identifying and addressing industrial affordability issues, working towards a more resilient economy across the board. So looking at what are the critical issues that if we don't solve them now, we'll have a huge economic impact in the future. One of those is addressing our ability to maintain distribution and manufacturing and repair functions in the city. And this is really critical because about 50% of our industrial businesses have said that they either are planning to leave the city within the next 2 years or are worried that they'll have to leave the city within the next 5 years. And so when you see that happen, it's not just that we're losing those jobs and those revenues and that kind of economic opportunity for our residents, but we're also losing a diversity of jobs. So about 50% of those jobs you don't require college education for, or you don't need to be in an office setting. In addition to that, the environmental impacts of that industrial displacement are massive. So if 70% of your clients are downtown and in the dense residential districts that are around your business, you have twice as many trucks on the road, twice as many GHG emissions, and twice as much congestion if that business is pushed out to the outskirts. So that's a really critical issue that we'll want to consider in this process.
Thanks so much. Do you mind sticking around for a couple minutes? We've got some questions that are coming. So what we'll do is what we've done before is I'll grab a few that you've submitted by cards, and then we'll have a few that you put your hands up. So.